Rounding the base of the mountains just below Quake Lake, the Madison turns north, winding through a broad valley of its own design. The Native Americans knew it first. For them, it was a sweet but unforgiving land of vast immensity, and they roamed it with the quiet intensity of those born to solitude. This land was the womb of their existence, and they paid it homage with their lives. Buffalo lived here too, but like the natives, they quickly became an anachronism, a symbol of untamed wildness, of freedom that few could understand. Now only their ghosts roam the hills. You can see them moving through the grasses when the wind blows, or feel them in the fragments of bone where they fell, crushed by those behind. Made to jump by the shams of men, they gave sustenance, shelter, and fuel. Now, not even the eldest can recall these great gifts of the buffalo. This broad, grassy valley of the Madison also served as the rendezvous for mountain men like Jeremiah Johnson, Jim Bridger, and John Bozeman. Here, amidst their clamorous gatherings, they traded stories, bartered for salt and flour, and contested their skills with rifle, knife, and hatchet. But their time is gone, and in this day, the bark of the rifle has been replaced by the more civilized sound of car door slamming, the clash of hatchet and bowie knife have become the clink of waiting staff and hobnailed brogue, and the boisterous songs of the mountain men have been silenced by the sonorous rasp of the flywheel. These modern-day mountain people have come seeking the past, the time when wildness roamed untethered over the golden hills of autumn or lay quietly among the new grasses of spring. But wildness is not a place, and it can't be intellectualized. It can only be seen with the eyes of the heart and heard with the ears of the soul. Here in the Cardinal Valley of the Madison, only the river recalls the wildness. That's why they come. And though they may not understand, the river does, and it receives them as a mother to her breast.